أهلا بحضراتكم يا دكاترة، في الجزء الرابع من مراجعة الجزء العملي الخاص بمقرر علم الطفيليات لكلية الصيدلة الجامعة الحديثة للتكنولوجيا والمعلومات MTI. Welcome doctors to Parasitology Course Practical Revision Part 4 of Faculty of Pharmacy Modern University for Technology and Information MTI. Let's start. We have said that the parasites are classified into helminths or worms, which are multicellular parasites, protozoa, which are unicellular parasites, and arthropods. We have finished talking about helminths, and now we are going to talk about protozoa and arthropods. As for protozoa, we have two examples of protozoa. Protozoa are unicellular organisms, كائنات وحيدة الخلية. We have two examples of protozoa, which are Trypanosoma species and Toxoplasma gondii. The class Trypanosoma species belong to class Mastigophora or flagellates, which are the protozoa which move by flagella. الماستيغوفورا هي الفلاجيليتس اللي هي البارازايتس اللي بتتحرك او البروتوزوا اللي بتتحرك بالفلاجيلا، عندها الفلاجيلا اللي هي الفلاجيلا اللي هي دي اللي هو ده اللي هو دي اللي هي بتتحرك بيه ده كده. While Toxoplasma gondii belong to class Sporozoa, which are non-motile protozoa. يعني Toxoplasma gondii ما عندهمش، دول non-motile ما بيتحركوش اصلا. Okay, let's start. The definitive or final host. In case of Trypanosoma species, the definitive host is man. While in case of Toxoplasma gondii, the definitive host is cat. Okay, the infective stage, which infects the definitive or final host. Infective stage in case of Trypanosoma species is called metacyclic trypomastigotes. Metacyclic trypomastigotes. But in case of Toxoplasma gondii, the infective stage, we have two infective stages here. Fecal spirillated oocysts and tissue cysts. What are fecal spirillated oocysts? Fecal spirillated oocysts are oocysts. They are like eggs. They are they come out with the feces of the cat. They are like eggs, but they are called oocysts. Tissue cysts. What are tissue cysts? They are the cysts which are found in the flesh or in the muscles of animals. We will talk about them briefly. يعني احنا هنتكلم على التوكسوبلازما جونديا نتذكرها بشكل مختصر كده بس نكمل الكلام. Okay. The infective stage has two items related to it. Item related to the past, which is the intermediate host, and an item related to the future, which is the mode of transmission or mode of infection. How the infective stage enters the body of the definitive host. As for the intermediate host in case of Trypanosoma species is a fly called tsetse fly or Glossina species. In this case, the tsetse fly is considered a vector. Okay? In case of Toxoplasma gondii, the intermediate hosts are man and cold and warm-blooded animals and birds, which contain only asexual stages, accidental or non-specific hosts. We mean that any host, any animal or bird can be an intermediate host in the case of Toxoplasma gondii. أي إنسان أو أي حيوان أو أي طائر سواء cold and warm blooded ممكن يبقوا intermediate hosts. Because all of these men or animals can eat food contaminated with fecal spirillated oocysts, or they can eat an animal containing the tissue cysts. Okay, so all these can be considered as intermediate host. The mode of infection or mode of transmission in the case of the Trypanosoma species is, we said before that if the intermediate host is an arthropod like tsetse fly, then the mode of infection or mode of transmission will be the bite of this fly or arthropod. And قلنا قبل كده في الفيديو اللي فات، لو احنا عندنا الانترميديت هوست كان حشرة زي في حالة كده الايه الانوفليس موسكيتو في حالة البشرية بانكروفتي، يبقى اكيد المود اوف انفكشن او مود اوف ترانسميشن هتبقى القرصة بتاعة الحشرة دي، the bite of this infected tsetse fly containing the infective stage metacyclic trypomastigotes. Okay. In the case of Toxoplasma gondii, there are four modes of infection or four modes of transmission. We said that we have two infective stages, either fecal aspirated oocysts or tissue cysts. These fecal aspirated oocysts can be found on food, can be ingested with contaminated food. Tissue cysts are found inside animals, so they can be transmitted by eating animals containing these tissue cysts. What are the modes of infection or modes of transmission? Number one, eating undercooked meat of animals harboring tissue cysts, as we said before. Consuming or food or water contaminated with cat feces and contaminated with fecal aspirated oocysts. Vertical transmission, which means transplacentally from mother to fetus. The mother may be infected with Toxoplasma gondii, so in her body she has what's called tachyzoites. If you remember, they are characterized by rapid multiplication. These tachyzoites can pass through the placenta and can be transmitted from mother to the fetus. The fourth mode of infection or fourth mode of transmission is blood transfusion or organ transplantation. Blood transfusion or organ transplantation. Blood transfusion if blood contains bradyzoites. Bradyzoites are they are characterized by slow multiplication. Okay, or organ transplantation if somebody was or had an organ transplantation and this organ contained tissue cysts. Okay. Then the parasite entered the body of the human, so it enters the body of the human body or the cat. Okay, now there is no habitat in this life cycles because we are talking about protozoa. They are unicellular organisms. They are not worms. They do not have an adult form. They are protozoa. So we will not talk about the habitat here or the location of adult worm here because we are not talking about an adult worm. We are talking about protozoa. هنا احنا بنتكلم على protozoa، كائنات أولية، كائنات وحيدة الخلية، مش دودة بقى صغيرة وبتكبر وكده. فهنا مفيش adult form، فبالتالي هنا مفيش habitat هنتكلم عليها. Okay, the diagnostic stage. In case of Trypanosoma species, the diagnostic stage is called bloodstream trypomastigotes in blood. Bloodstream trypomastigotes in blood. The infective stage is called the metacyclic trypomastigotes, but the diagnostic stage is called the bloodstream trypomastigotes. The bloodstream trypomastigotes, from their name, they are found in blood. In case of Toxoplasma gondii, the diagnostic stage is tissue cysts which are formed inside the body. Okay, the name of the disease. In case of Trypanosoma species, the disease is called sleeping sickness, مرض النوم. While in case of Toxoplasma gondii, the disease is called toxoplasmosis. Toxoplasmosis. طيب علشان يعني نختصر او باختصار كده اللايف سايكل بتاعت التوكسوبلازما جوندياي عباره عن ايه؟ قلنا الكات بتبقى هي الديفينتيف او فاينل هوست. الكات بينزل مع الفيسز بتاعتها حاجه اسمها سبوريليتد اوسيستس. حلو؟ فلو بني ادم او اي حيوان او طائر كل اكل كونتامينيتد بالكات فيسز اللي هي فيها سبوريليتد اوسيستس يحصل له الانفكشن. جميل. طيب هل بس ده الوحيد الانفكتيف ستيج للانسان؟ لا، في حاجه تانية انفكتيف ستيج للانسان اللي هي التيشو سيستس. التيشو سيستس دي عباره عن ايه؟ دي بتتكون جوه جسم اي كائن عنده الانفكشن، بتتكون جوه جسمه في التيشوز بتاعته حاجه اسمها التيشو سيست اللي هي التيشو سيستس دي. خلاص تمام. طيب احنا اتفقنا عامه ان اي بني ادم خلاص او اي كائن هيحصل له الانفكشن جوه جسمه، سواء السبيريتد اوسيستس ديت لو البني ادم او الكائن ده كال سبيريتد اوسيستس او كال حيوان جواه تيشوسيستس، في الحالتين الاتنين دولت بيتحولوا في جسمه لفورم اسمها تاكيزويتس. تاكي يعني سريع، تاكيزويتس يعني بيعملوا رابيد مالتيبليكيشن. طيب التاكيزويتس دي بعد كده بتروح للتيشوز بتاعة الكائن ده وتتحول لتيشو سيستس. التيشو سيستس ديت بيبقى اسمها ايه؟ خلاص بيبقى اسمها براديزويتس، يعني اللي جوه التيشو سيستس ديت بتبقى اسمها براديزويتس، يعني المالتيبليكيشن بتاعها بيبقى سلو. جميل كده، حلو قوي. يبقى اي كائن هياكل سبريتد اوسيستس او تيشو سيستس، الاثنين دول هتحولوا في جسم الكائن ده الاول لتاكيزويتس، بعد كده يروحوا التيشوز يتحولوا لبراديزويتس. فاي كائن بعد كده، صح، حلو قوي. فاي كائن زي ما قلنا هياكل كائن تاني جواه تيشو سيستس، هيحصل جواه نفس الموضوع، التيشو سيستس هتتحول جواه لتاكيزويتس بعد كده لبراديزويتس. طيب فبالنسبه للبني ادم قلنا لو كل اندركوكد ميت اوف انيمالز هاربرنج تيشو سيستس يحصل له الانفكشن، لو كل اكل كونتامينيتد بالكات فيسز برضه يحصل له الانفكشن. طب لو ام عندها الانفكشن خلاص وفي جسمها في التاكيزويتس، التاكيزويتس دي تعدي خلال البلاسنتا منها للفيتس ويحصل الانفكشن. طب لو الشخص ده اتنقل له دم والدم ده كان فيه البراديزويتس، خلاص البني ادم يحصل له الانفكشن. او لو البني ادم اتنقل له عضو والعضو دوت كان فيه تيشو سيستس، برضه البني ادم يحصل له الانفكشن. جميل. طيب so briefly the life cycle of Toxoplasma gondii. The cat is the definitive or final host. The cat feces will contain spirulated oocysts of this parasite. So if a man or any animal or bird ingests food contaminated with cat feces and containing this spirulated oocysts, infection will occur. Also, if any animal or man eats another animal containing tissue cysts of the Toxoplasma gondii, then the infection will also occur. In either way, if man or animal ingests oocysts or tissue cysts, both will be converted inside the body of the man or the animal will be converted into tachyzoites. These are characterized by rapid multiplication. After this, these tachyzoites will go to tissues of this animal and will be converted to bradyzoites, which are characterized by slow multiplication. These bradyzoites are called tissue cysts. So, if man ingests tissue cysts by eating undercooked meat of animals, or consumed food or water contaminated with cat feces containing spirulated oocysts, or there was vertical transmission, which means a mother who is infected with Toxoplasma gondii, the tachyzoites in her body will cross the placenta and pass to her fetus. Finally, in case of blood transfusion, if blood transfusion occurred and this blood contained bradyzoites, or if organ transplantation occurred and this organ contained tissue cysts, in all these cases infection will occur. And in all these cases oocysts or tissue cysts are converted to tachyzoites and then go into tissues and converted into bradyzoites or tissue cysts. That's why the diagnostic stage for man is tissue cysts. The spots are, in case of Trypanosoma species, we see trypomastigotes in blood. Bloodstream trypomastigotes. These are the bloodstream trypomastigotes. We can see them and we can see RBCs, red blood cells, surrounding them. If we couldn't see these trypomastigotes and we just saw red blood cells and blood cells in the field, then this is trypomastigotes in blood. In case of Toxoplasma gondii, the spot that we see is the tachyzoites of Toxoplasma. Tachyzoites, as we said before, they are characterized by rapid multiplication. When man or any animal ingests oocysts or tissue cysts, oocysts or tissue cysts are converted in his body into tachyzoites and then they go into a tissue and are converted to bradyzoites or tissue cysts. Tachyzoites have crescent-like shape or curved shape. بيبقى شبه كده الهلال، خلاص شكلها كيرفت كده شبه الهلال، او تبقى شبه الايه الضوافر بالمنظر ده. They are curved like brackets or have crescent-like shape. And they have this color. finally we are going to talk about arthropods, الحشرات. Okay, arthropods that we are going to talk about are or fall under one of two classes, class Insecta and class Arachnida. Okay, we have four examples of class Insecta and two examples of class Arachnida. The examples of class Insecta are number one, flea. Flea in Arabic. بالعربي الفلي اللي هو الايه البرغوت. Okay, what is the medical importance of flea? Number one, they are vector of plague. Plague اللي هو الطاعون, بينقلوا الطاعون. Number two, they are intermediate host for Hymenolepis diminuta and Diplodium caninum or Diplodium caninum. As we said before, the intermediate host of Diplodium caninum or Diplodium caninum is dog flea. برغوت الكلاب هو اللي بينقل الدايبليديم كانينم او كانينم زي ما قلنا قبل كده. Number 3, flea transmit endemic or murine typhus. This is a disease, the name of a disease. Okay, typhus has two forms, either endemic or epidemic. The endemic type is transmitted by murine fleas. Murine means rodents or mice. Murine يعني فيران. لأن ال endemic typhus ده بيتنقل بال rat flea. خلاص, أو البرغوث بتاع الفيران أو القوارض دي. Number two, the second example of a class Insecta is bed bug, بق الفراش. It causes this bed bug, they annoy us while sleeping. So they cause irritation, insomnia. يعني بيعملوا لنا ايه irritation, كأن واحد عايز يعني ايه يهرش او كده. insomnia, أرق, واحد ما يعرفش ينام. and allergic dermatitis, التهاب جلدي بسبب البيت بج. number 3, louse, louse is the singular, the plural of louse is lice, اللي هي الأمل. اللوس اللي هي الأملة جمعها lice. Louse or lice cause pediculosis. Pediculosis is the case of infection or infestation of louse or lice, because the genus name for louse or lice is pediculus. So the case of infection with pediculus or louse or lice is called pediculosis. يعني دي معناها ان شخص مصاب بالأمل. Also louse transmits trench fever and epidemic typhus. Trench fever, trench is the place where soldiers stay during wars. Trench يعني خندق. خلاص, louse transmits, بتنقل trench fever, خلاص لو حمى الخندق. And epidemic typhus, not endemic, epidemic typhus. Okay, trench fever of course is transmitted due to crowded conditions. يعني trench fever ده بيحصل خلاص في الظروف اللي بيبقى فيها زحام زي مثلا في الخنادق. طيب, the fourth example of class Insecta is Anopheles mosquito. Anopheles mosquito of course, the female Anopheles mosquito transmits malaria, بتنقل malaria. Class Arachnida, we have two examples, hard and soft tick. خلاص, tick اللي هو القراد, القراد الصلب, hard tick, هو soft tick اللي هو القراد اللين. The medical importance, number one, mechanically they bite and cause bleeding, بيقرصوا وبيعملوا bleeding نزيف. Systematically they cause tick paralysis, بيعملوا شلل. They could also transmit a disease called Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever. Finally, the second example of class Arachnida is called scabies mites or Sarcoptes scabii. Mite اللي هي العتة, خلاص. Scabies mite اللي هي بتاعت الجرب, العتة بتاعت الجرب, خلاص. فطالما هي بتاعت الجرب يبقى هتكون بتعمل ايه اكيد؟ intense itching, which leads to disturbed sleep. بتعمل هرش جامد قوي, فده هيؤدي ان الواحد ما يعرفش ينام, تؤدي لبليدنج, leads to bleeding and secondary bacterial infection. Okay, finally the spots, الشيب او شكل الحشرات دي. Number one, class Insecta. Class Insecta are characterized by having three pairs of legs. They have six legs. انسكتا ستة، انسكتا ستة، يبقى الحشرات اللي تبع كلاس انسكتا عندهم كام رجل؟ 6 أرجل. نمبر 1 فلي، البرغوت. the shape of bar, the shape of flea we see it we see the side of flea. It's the only insect in our course that we see from one side. دايما بنشوفها بالجنب الفلي دي، وزي ما احنا شايفين عندها 3 أرجل. It has يعني شايفين طبعا 3 أرجل عشان احنا شايفين ناحية واحدة. We see 3 legs because we see flea from one side. Of course the posterior legs are the tallest or the or sorry they are the longest legs. يعني رجلها اللي في الآخر دي بتبقى أطول رجل. Okay, we have bed bug بق الفراش and louse اللي هو الأملة. They have we see them not from their sides. No, we see them completely. We can see their abdomen. They have 6 legs or 3 pairs of legs, as we can see. 6 legs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, how can we differentiate between bedbug and louse? ازاي بنفرق ما بينهم؟ Number 1, the shape of their legs. شكل رجليهم. The leg of bedbug is similar to that of the cockroach. يعني رجل البيت باج، رجل بقى الفراش، بيبقى شبه رجل الصرصار كده، خلاص بتبقى بالمنظر ده. While the leg of louse looks as if it has hooks. يعني كأن رجليها فيها خطافات، كأن رجلين الأملة فيها زي خطافات، عاملة زي رجل الكابوريا كده، خلاص عاملة زي رجل زي ايه، كأن فيها خطافات. The abdomen of bed bug contain complete segments, as we can see. We can see the lines, the segments in the abdomen of bed bug, while the segments in the abdomen of louse are incomplete. يعني احنا بنقدر نشوف الخطوط كاملة في بطن البيت بوغ، لكن ما نقدرش، لكن مش بتبقى كاملة في بطن اللاوس او الاملة. Also we can see the mouth parts of female and male anopheles mosquitoes. بنقدر نشوف وش ال anopheles mosquito، الميل او الفيميل. Okay, how can we differentiate between the mouth parts of female and male anopheles mosquito? By their antenna. Antenna قرون الاستشعار. Antenna قرون الاستشعار. The male is always hairy, so the male antenna is hairy. We can see hair around the antenna. It looks like a feather. يعني الميل دايما بيبقى هو المشعر، اللي عنده شعر اكتر، فالانتنة او قرون الاستشعار بتاعت الميل زي ما احنا بنشوف كده بيبقى فيها زي الايه، زي الشعر ده، خلاص بيبقى فيها زي الايه، الشعر ده كده، تمام. But the antenna of the female has no hair. It's not hairy. Okay? Okay. We should recognize the antenna and differentiate it from the proboscis of the mouth of the anopheles mosquito. The proboscis is used by the anopheles mosquito to suck blood, so we should not concentrate on them. We will see the proboscis surrounded by 2 appendages, so that we can see 3 appendages. The appendage in the middle, which is the proboscis, and the 2 other appendages. We should not concentrate on the 3 appendages beside each other. We should concentrate on the other 2 appendages. These are the antenna. These are not the antenna. The 3 appendages here are not the antenna. The antenna are the other 2 appendages. And the same thing here. This is not the antenna. We can see 3 appendages here. These are not the antenna. The antenna are the other 2 appendages. يعني احنا لما هنبص على وش الناموسة هنلاقي 3 زوايد او 3 عصيان كده جنب بعض، ما لناش دعوة بيهم. ديت اللي ايه، اللي في النص، العصاية في النص ديت اللي هي البروبوسكس، المصة بتاعت الناموسة اللي بتمص بيها الدم. فال3 عصيان جنب بعض دول مش الانتنة، دول مش قولون الاستشعار بتاعت الناموسة، فما لناش دعوة بيهم. قولون الاستشعار فين؟ الاتنين التانيين اللي بعض عن بعض دول، خلاص. The two antenna are far away from each other. ديس ار دي انتنا، خلاص هي ديت الانتنا بتاعتنا. هنا برضه نفس الكلام، التلاته اللي جنب بعض ملناش دعوه بيهم، احنا الانتنا بتبقى بعاد عن بعض، اللي هي قنوات الاستشعار بتاعت الناموس بتبقى بعيد عن بعضها بالمنظر ده. So this is the mouth part of male anopheles mosquito and this is the mouth part of female anopheles mosquito. اوكي كلاس اراكنيدا. اراكنيدا بالعربي يعني ايه؟ ده يعني ايه؟ العنكبوتيات، اسمها العنكبوتيات، خلاص دي كلاس بتاعت العنكبوتيات. والعنكبوت بيبقى عنده كام رجل؟ عنده 8 ارجل. So class Araknida are characterized by 4 pairs of legs. Already have 8 legs، عندهم 8 ارجل. The examples of class Araknida are hard tick, soft tick and Sarcoptes scabii. Sarcoptes scabii or the scabies mite. طيب what's the difference between hard tick and soft tick؟ both of them have 8 legs، الاثنين عندهم 8 ارجل، but the hard tick we can see this part is more brown than the rest of the body. This part can be either till half of the insect or it can reach the entire body of the insect. This part is called scutum, which is a hard part. It's like a shield that protects this insect. That's why we called it hard tick. يعني ليه هي اسمها وراد صلب؟ علشان الجزء ده عامل زي الدرع بالنسبة لها، الجزء البني غامق ده بيبقى اسمه سكيوتم. خلاص السكيوتم ده يا اما بيبقى لحد النص كده، خلاص عند الميل، عند الفيميل اسف، بيبقى لحد النص كده. عند الميل بقى ممكن السكيوتم ده بتلاقيه طويل خالص كده، ممكن لغاية اخر الايه الحشرة. فعامة سواء شفت المنظر ده حشرة عندها 8 ارجل وعندها الجزء البني غامق ده للنص او للاخر، بداية الهارد تيك. خلاص يبقى the hard tick is an insect with 8 legs and it has this scutum which can reach the middle of the insect or it can reach the or it can cover the entire body of the insect. In case of soft tick, the soft tick is an insect with 8 legs and it does not have the scutum. And we can feel that its body looks like the tortoise or turtle's shell. يعني ظهرها ده عامل ازاي او جسمها عامل زي قوقعة السلحفة. هنشوف حشرة عندها 8 ارجل، ممكن نشوفها كده بالمنظر ده، خلاص ونحس ان ظهرها عامل زي قوقعة السلحفة. And its body covers a great part of the legs. We can see a small part of the legs because its body covers a great part of the legs. يعني جسمها بيغطي جزء كبير من ال legs. And its body looks like turtles or tortoises shell. يعني ظهرها او جسمها عامل زي قوقعة السلحفة او ظهر السلحفة، وظهرها او جسمها ده مغطي جزء كبير من رجلها. اوكي finally the Sarcoptes scabii or the scabies mite. خلاص its shape is characteristic. Its shape is circular like that and its legs are small. يعني تبقى هي حشرة مدورة كده، خلاص ورجليها تبقى طالعة كده صغيرة. and it's colorless. we feel that they are colorless. بتبقى ايه، بنحس ان لونها colorless، ملهاش لون تحت السلايد. طيب this is the end of parasitology course practical revision part 4. ده كده نهاية الجزء الرابع من مراجعة الجزء العملي الخاص بمقرر علم الطفيليات. بالتوفيق يا دكاترة. Good luck doctors.